Good morning, I'm Clinton Griffiths. President-elect Trump has talked about increasing tariffs on foreign goods, particularly on those from China. He has argued such import taxes would help keep manufacturing jobs in the U.S., shrink the federal deficit, and help lower food prices. The possible tariff increase already having an impact on commodity markets. Ag Day's Michelle Rook joins me. And Michelle, market watchers are keeping a close eye on this.
Well, they are, Clinton, and actually the ag markets have held up considerably well under tariff threats made by the Trump administration, especially regarding China and Mexico. Now, market analysts say this is partially due to ideas of continued end-user front-loading before Trump officially takes office. Plus, the U.S. may be better prepared to handle a trade war than it was in 2018.
With the threat of tariffs and a trade war, ag markets, especially soybeans, were bracing for fallout tied to the re-election of former President Trump. However, analysts say the markets have been holding together due to anticipation of continued strong demand before January 20th.
Are we going to see a big push of exports, you know, between now and mid-January, trying to front run those tariffs just out of fear with the unknown, not knowing exactly, you know, what those actual numbers are going to be.
End users have been buying soybean oil with Trump's threat to ban or tax used cooking oil imports from China. And China has ramped up soybean purchases with threats of up to 60% tariffs.
Chinese have been very aggressive buyers over the last couple of months, you know, trying to bring in a lot before any potential closing of the door, if you will.
But even Mexico may be concerned with campaign rhetoric of 25% tariffs if the government doesn't help solve the border crisis.
I believe Mexico and Japan and some of the other players have been maybe front running this election a little bit as well.
Soybean farmers still feel the sting of the China trade war in 2018 when prices had an 8 handle on them. But it also came with a phase one deal. So there's hope a Trump administration will hold a hard line on Beijing.
But I think long term it'll be positive for soybeans because, look, they don't buy much else from us. And so I think Trump will hold their feet to the fire when it comes to soybeans. But that's going to be longer term stuff. We're talking well out into 2025.
Remember, some Chinese tariffs remain from 2018, and China's more dependent on South America. Plus, the U.S. diversified its export portfolio, especially for soybeans, which may mute the impact of a trade war.
The industry made a lot of changes after the 2018-2019 trade war. There was a lot of production moved out of China into Vietnam and Cambodia and places like that.
Ann Brugler says Trump plans to use the tariffs to offset his tax cuts. So Congress will also have a say on tariffs because it will impact the budget. I'm Michelle Rourke reporting for Ag Day.